In this illustration, we'll analyze the energy of an oscillating climbed string. We are given that a uniform string of length L is fixed at both ends such that a tension T is produced in it. And if second overtone is set up in the string by an external oscillating source, so that the maximum amplitude of oscillations in a string is E naught, we are required to calculate the maximum kinetic energy of the string for its oscillations. Now, in this situation for solution, we can first draw the figure of this string, where second overtone is set up, which is corresponding to third harmonic oscillations. If the string is clamped between two fixed clamps, then it will be oscillating in three loops, as we are given that a second overtone is induced in it. And the amplitude of NT node is given to us as E naught. And as we are also given that the tension in a string is to be taken as T. So here we can write, if the left end is considered an origin, then at a distance x from this clamp, if the amplitude of oscillation of a particle is R, we can write, which we already studied in concept videos, that amplitude of oscillation at a distance x from clamped end is, this we can write as R, and we write it as A naught sine kx. And in this situation, as the length of a string is L, here we can use L is equals to 3 lambda by 2 for third harmonic oscillation, which gives us the value of lambda, which is 2L by 3. So in this situation, the value of R we are getting is A naught sine of K, we can write as 2 pi by lambda, which is 2L by 3. Multiplied by x. So we are getting this value of R as A naught sine of 3 pi x by L. So this relation gives us the amplitude as a function of x for all the particles in the medium. And for second overtone, frequency of oscillations of a string, if we calculate, this frequency of oscillation we can write as n is equals to 3v by 2l, which we can write as 3 by 2l root of t by mu. The v velocity we can write as square root of the ratio of tension to linear mass density. And if we consider an element of width dx over here, which is oscillating at an amplitude r about the same mean position, we can write for an element of a string, of width dx, we are required to find the maximum kinetic energy of a string for its oscillation. And for an element of a string of width dx, maximum kinetic energy is given as, this we can write as dE, which is half, its mass will be taken as mu dx omega square r square. So on substituting the value of r, this will give us half mu omega square A naught square sine square 3 pi x by L multiplied by dx. Now, in this situation here, if we substitute the value of omega also, which will be 4, 2 pi n, so omega square will be 4 pi square n square. If this value of n we put it here, this gives half mu, and omega will be 2 pi n, so this is a square will be 4 pi square multiplied by n square here is 9 by 4 L square multiplied by T by mu multiplied by A naught square sine square 3 pi x by L dx. Here you can see this mu gets cancelled out and 4 also gets cancelled out. So the value of this DE we are getting is, this is 9 by 2 pi square T A square, A naught square divided by L square multiplied by sin square 3 pi x by L dx. Now if we continue from here, then total energy, maximum kinetic energy of a string we can write as integration of DE, and the constant terms can be taken as it is 9 pi square T A naught square by L square integration of sin square 3 pi x by L dx, and we integrate it from 0 to L. And this you can easily integrate by transforming it in twice angle form of cosine. So this E we can write as 9 pi square T A naught square by L square, and this integration from 0 to L we can write it 1 minus cos of 6 pi x by L whole divided by 2 dx. I leave this simple integration as an exercise for you, that you can integrate it and verify the result you'll be getting is 9 pi square A naught square T divided by 4L. That is the result of this problem.